Okay, I'm ready to go. I've got this all cleaned off. I'm clean as a whistle. No little snigglies of any kind of thing that are going to stop my, my connection. I made sure that there was no glue or anything like that. So let's get at it. I got to work fast. You're going to see I'm going to try to race like crazy. And I've got... Like I said, I'm probably going to make a bit of a mess, but I'll clean it off. It's the inside of a downdraft table. It's not a jewelry box. See, I don't skimp on glue. Glue's cheap. You can see this is skinning over so fast in this heat. Okay, I gotta race. I gotta get going now. There's no... Pontificating. I'm ready for this heat to break. I'm tired of it. I am tired. But it hasn't been as bad as it could be. But that's not going to stop me from whining about it. It's been for Texas, it's been pretty reasonable. Because I've seen some unreasonable summers. A couple years ago when I was doing that, when I made those mallets, oh man, that was like 107 to 10 degrees to higher every single day during that build. And I was sick too. That was the hottest summer ever. Get this all aligned. Looking good, looking good. Looking good. Oh, I like it. I like it. Okay, let me start getting this guy pinned down. panic attack right there for just a second. See, that's why you want to get your glues pinned together fast, so it'll give you time. Otherwise, if it's exposed to the air, since it works by evaporation, that's what's gonna make the glue react too fast and not work for you. So now that I got it, now it's not in the atmosphere anymore. It's between these two pieces. I've got a little bit of breathing room. Okay, let's get our screws going. I'm gonna try one first, kind of here in the middle into this mahogany, without piloting it, see what it feels like. Oh, these are the new ones with the. They've gone to a Torx bit. That I didn't take into account. Let's see. Oh, I think I can do the mahogany ones, no problem. Felt a little tight. I don't want to snap any off. Let's just do this. On this side, except for one block being blocked by the clamp. So let me get going. Perfect. That feels right. Tell you, these 2-inch screws, they feel right. They feel like they're... They're just pulling and making this thing a rock-solid connection. I say these Torx are nice. They grab. Okay, I think I have made every one. Okay, let's take a look and see what kind of mess I got going underneath here. Let's deal with it right now. There's no reason to let it set up and. Oh, that's not too bad. I'm gonna just leave it. I'll just peel it with the chisel. I can't justify getting smearing all this stuff all over the place here. It's not worth it. Man, that's what you call a solid connection. Let's see what we got going on here. So here's Mentu Toyo. Let's see what we got. Ooh, that's as flat as can. That's as flat can be right there. It's hard to improve on for wood. The beauty of this is it will stay like this. You know, you got this rigid frame. It's rigid. Now you've got this pinned down to that flat surface, glued and screwed. It'd be hard for this to torque and misbehave.